All right, guys, another Patreon month. This month, the album we hit was The Rise and Fall of Ziggy Stardust. That's actually out already on Patreon.
And by overwhelming popular demand, the movie we're going to hit a little later this month is The Kids Are All Right, apparently a music movie regarding The Who.
Really excited about that. We also have two singles that will be dropping throughout the month of individual reactions, plus access to the full Discord. If you're not there, you need to be. It's super fun. We're hanging out, getting music suggestions there. All this for less than a cup of coffee, as well as the hundreds of back cataloged reactions, albums, movies, singles. Go on there. We'll see you.
Hey guys, hope you're having a great day. It was a great life. Alex's shirt is ridiculous. Let's call it out right now.
I don't think it's ridiculous at all. This is a great shirt.
I love the shirt.
I am colorblind, so that could definitely be a factor.
It's funny. Yeah. I called it a little earlier. You're like, no, it's pink.
Yeah.
It's like, you know what it is.
To me, it's like a very light pink.
But what is pink to you compared to pink to me?
I don't know.
That's the question of the universe.
That's a really tough one.
But all I'm saying is, if someone's going to rock it on this channel, it's definitely you and not me.
I definitely love ridiculous outfits, and you do understand that. So.
Yep. So, very excited to hit this. We had a poll with a lot of artists in a similar vein as this, and we read the Spotify About section for this group, and apparently they kind of like fronted punk before punk really had terminology. They had like glam aspects from like T-Rex, David Bowie, some vibey stuff from
just
like
a really good collection
Rolling
of
Stones, rock and roll esque, like just a bunch of
yeah,
weird things that
all kind of in this melting pot that don't really seem like they would fit, but they in retrospect they kind of do fit. So it's like,
yeah,
I agree with that. Yeah. Also, another reason I'm wearing pink is because they have the New York Dolls written in like pink lipstick on the cover. Look at that. That's why.
I like it.
It's definitely why, and not just because I picked it. So, yeah, before we get started, make sure you're subscribed, and let's just get into it.
Let's do it.
Oh, okay.
Well, we can't take her this way, and her friends don't want another stage. Hoping for a
Dang, dude. I'm
so torn.
That's a lot.
I am in a vast emptiness of not knowing what to do.
Can I just not? Can you just tell me what you are going to rate it?
I'm torn between two ratings. If you want, I can spoil what I'm torn between.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm torn between A and A plus, to be honest with you. Oh, I freaking loved it. I thought it was like immaculate. Not in every sense of the way, but in a lot of ways.
Okay, I think maybe an A then for me.
Okay.
There's just this...
I'm leaning A too. It just felt so freaking creative. Like,
when? What year was this again?
Gosh, I think 73.
Yeah, 73. That's so cool. So just the way he's singing and the whole ambiance of the whole thing, the yelling, like the... It feels so unhinged and chaotic.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It literally feels like somebody like losing their sanity. Yeah. Well, actually, no. They walked into the building, sanity's already gone, and they further like deteriorated.
Yeah. The only thing I wish was different slightly, and it got like, you know, higher in like later in the song, but I like early on when they were kind of like, doing some shouting stuff, it was a little low, and I was like, turn the mics up, let's go. You know what I mean? Like I wanted to hear him like shouting, you know.
Honestly, I didn't even mind that. I love that it was like, because you could still pick it out, so you knew it was there, and it almost made you want it more.
No, you know exactly. It's to their benefit. You know what I mean? God, so cool. And the thing is, like, from what a lot of people were saying, is this band never got heavy like worldwide recognition, but regionally in like in the United States had a, kind of like a big, you know, cluster of a following.
Yeah.
So interesting. The New York Dolls. So ballsy, too. 1973, and it's like they're all dressing in drag.
Yeah.
On the album cover, like lipstick, like they're leaning into it hard.
Yeah, it and literally feels like they're trying to be as counterculture as possible. And musically, like they have like these blues kind of scales over them just screaming in the mic at points. It's like.
It even started like the guitar from the beginning, very blues rooted.
Yeah.
Gosh. And I freaking love when they use like high keys for like.
Yeah,
tension. Like, that's one of my favorite things in music. Honestly, is throwing high keys.
Just
like
really, really cool. This is
the drums were awesome.
If you were like, any band that was like doing punk music or grunge music or anything, following them, it's like you have to have them on your radar. This has to be one of the bands you listen to.
Yeah, and it just feels like if you're going to see like a live performance, like you want to see something like this. This feels like it has like the essence of rock and roll, like in its roots. Yeah. Like really, just I think the word you use when we start talking about it, like the best word, unhinged. That is exactly how this feels. And at the end, especially at the end when they shouted extra, they shouted the whole song. But at the end, especially when it was like they were screaming it, it was like, gosh, it's like contagious, like the energy.
I feel like if I was seeing a concert from them, I would know as an audience member, just from this one song, that there is no rules that apply to them because they don't even care if they get paid. Like, it seems like they'll tear down a stage, really? Like, call the cops. Like, what are you going to say? Like, some dude in a wig, like, you don't know. I'm going to do whatever I want. And then just tear the place apart or play the best show of their life. One of the two, and I'm down for either of it.
Saying that reminds me of, like, I forget, like, which tour, like, the Who were on, but Keith Moon, like, just caused so much damage that he actually lost money on the tour of one of their huge, like, biggest albums.
Yeah, we did a video on that back in the day.
Oh, was that like, a fact you gave me?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. But yeah, geez, this was awesome.
Really cool.
Oh, so the poll that we posted, I think, had some other artists that are in a similar vein. Let us know which from that poll we should hit next, or just other artists that are like we're also kind of doing a similar thing early on, like these guys were. Another like influence that you know Spotify said this band had was like the Stooges. Is that a band that we hit a song from or no?
I think we might have.
Frick, what was the one song? Fuck. You know what I'm talking about?
I do. Let me look it up.
It was like a late 60s, like super intense banger that we hit.
Okay, so we looked it up for like 5 minutes. Turns out we were both thinking MC4. Well, you were thinking MC5, Kick Out the Jams. So we were hitting those Stooges. So let us know when we're going
to
hit that. And
I feel like MC5 had to inspire these guys a little bit too.
It's true. What year was that?
That unhinged. I think it was like 69, 68. Like it was in the
60s. That was pretty crazy.
It's early, baby.
Yeah. Okay. Let us know. With that being said, see you in the next video.
Peace.
Thank you guys for watching the video. If you want to see more content from us, there's going to be a suggested video for us right there. If you want to see some unreleased stuff, you guys know the drill. On Patreon, less than a cup of coffee, go treat yourself.